JF. Add more flavor.
It's Motivation Wednesday on Joba Flavored once again, my lovely people. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending, of course, on what time you're listening to the program. It's your host, Lotta, and once again, we have a wonderful guest on the show, Mr. Mzwakile Twala. Yes. Yeah, how are you doing, bro?
I'm good, and yourself?
No, I'm perfect, my man. I'm perfect. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
Awesome stuff. All right, awesomeness, my man. So, your love for the guitar, like, when did it start, man?
Grade 4.
Grade 4.
Yes, after consistent listening of music, that's when I picked up Gutsi Indlebe and pays more attention to the guitar. And the whole PC music, most of the time I realized Gutsi, I can pick up the guitar.
Yeah.
And as time went on, you know, I could I'm not a good singer though, but then I could sing in my solos, you know, most of the songs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Including Nalo Spanish guitar.
Why am I not surprised? Nah, that's great, man. Yeah. That's great. So, one thing I'm picking up from that is that Mzwakile pays attention to detail.
Yes, yes. And
that's a life lesson on its own. It's not necessarily a fact, a challenge, or rather an issue for one to focus on many things. But the fact that in the midst of chaos or controlled chaos, you are able to focus on this one thing,
yes,
and, you know, pluck it out and analyze it and actually learn and grow from it.
Yes.
That's some crazy skill right there.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
You.
Of course, being a musician at all and falling in love with the guitar at such a tender age, I'm sure there were challenges here and there because, you know, resources are not easily available to some of us creatives. Yeah. So how did you go about that, man? You know?
Okay. You know, on that one, I feel good ngulunguluwa banam because ngaba exposed to an environment whereby I met people leba kona kungisita with the love of music, specifically guitar, you know, Konde Free Evangelical.
Yes.
So at that time, we had guys that were already playing, Musa Cage Lamini, John Philip, at that time they were playing, so I went straight to them and I asked them, "Gutsingila ningfunzisen?" And luckily enough, they were cool guys, bangfunzisa, and you know, from then I picked up all that they could teach me at that time because so magvalitikole, yeah, we came together, they taught me, and then after that we went back to, you know, the different places, so we never had that much time.
Yeah.
But then whatever that they taught me, funny thing is, till today, ngisak apply. I never had my own guitar though. So in a way, ngiyekongitsi ngulunguluwa banam, wang exposure to, you know, an environment whereby the corner would follow the resources that I need to push, you know, the gift. Let me put it like that.
The lessons just keep on flowing out of you, bro. Like, I feel like after every line, I have to analyze and scrutinize and share. Like, what I picked up from that now is that as an individual, you have to be bold.
Yes.
With your skill. And don't be afraid to take the first step. To attain what you want.
Yes.
You know, you felt the passion for learning the guitar. And instead of just saying, "Oh, nam something dawdlala," and sat there in the corner, you identified people that play, and out of respect approached them and said, "Ngani ngifundisa
ngosi
yami." And them being them, of course, they helped out. Secondly, diligence. The little time that you had with the instrument, yeah, but you didn't take it for granted. But you made the most of every second.
Yes.
And look at where you are today. You know, so shout out to that, man. Shout out to that.
Thank you.
Okay, so your first guitar, how did it come about? Like, what's that up? I mean, eventually after returning the world.
I had to. So what happened was, whiling sa funza with the guitar that Bomusa had lended me.
Yes.
Bomage bebabona kuthi okay, uyawuthanda music and stuff like that. And she paid attention to that, yeah. Especially my mom.
Yeah.
So she paid attention to that, and I'm suspecting maybe Beba Kuluma and Asiswa. Okay, yes, good. Yeah. Hey, Palamzwakile, you know, he's into this guitar thing. So, you know, as time went on, Babu Nangkubega, because I think sometimes Batali Bane would say, ah, maybe it's just a phase.
Yes.
But meaning Nangkubega and Mam Nani, you know, offered to buy me one.
Mm.
Now that's how I got one. Wow. Still nalapho njengoba ngisho solo ngulungulu unami, because look, mamncane, you know, it's exactly like offering, and you know, it's not directly my parents, but then nemvu who's close, like yes, around the circle,
exactly
lo bese ubona that gift uthi no, let me buy you something, because you've been keeping on with this thing for some time now. So that's how I got my first guitar, classical guitar.
So long ya ba. So is another lesson from that.
Okay.
Another lesson from that is that we need strong support systems.
Yes.
And yes, it's so helpful and so wonderful to know, Gusi, the people we live with and share our lives with daily, actually paying attention to the things that we do.
Mm.
And it's quite crucial that they take note of these small things,
yes,
the gifts that we have from a tender age, and invest in them.
Yes.
You know, because you never know what the future holds.
Yeah.
You know, you might be the next Leonardo. Oh no, that's a painter.
Yeah.
But yeah,
still in the art.
Yeah, still in the art side. Yes, yes. Say exactly. So Jay, likusasa li very wide and abounding. So, oh man, that's great. That's great. So, do you play professionally? In terms of, do you play for yourself or do you play for other artists? What kind?
Okay. Well, ngidlala for myself most of the time, and then I also play for other artists as well.
Mm.
So now, coming to the part where I play for myself, you know, I think Kulunguluwangi had this gift because it has a certain role idlalako empilweni yami, in terms of refreshing my spirit. I've noticed kutsi no matter how much of a tough day I can have, but then immediately I touch the guitar and I start playing, ingqondo yami iba refreshed, and I'm so creative as if I never worked that day.
The whole day.
Yes. So I don't know kutsi iswitcha njani, but anyways, ngulungulu yati, and it helps me kakhulu, kakhulu. So, you know, that's the part for playing for myself.
Mm-hmm.
And then, yes, I also do play for other artists as well, which is also interesting because I get to learn a lot.
Different approaches.
Yes, and another thing that I also realized for other artists is the fact that mina I play, you know, in the house a lot. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I'm used to doing things solo. Then when you get to work with other people,
team member,
yes, and you also learn to take instructions. Because, you know, playing, you know, I'm creative and I do a lot of things to whatever song that I'm working on. But then sometimes, you know, you don't need too many gimmicks on the song. You just need something simple. And it's hard. It's hard to learn. No, we just need that. Taking instructions.
Mm.
So in a way, Gwang Funza Sak by team member, yes.
Hey, big man. Need to develop. And learn to be a team member as well. Because in order for one to lead, you have to follow first.
Yes. Yes.
I know. So, in all these years playing the guitar, what has kept you going? I mean, Jay, what has kept you so focused in not losing this bond that you have?
It's the creativity that keeps coming. This is going to be interesting. Mangsaqala, you know, I listen to a lot of the music that plays on radio, like Msakato Angwane, which was good because, still is, because most of Letingoma Lebati Dlalagwe has a lot of content in music that is good. Understand? So, as Ngsakula, you know, I listen to, you know, soft rock, And then Mangkubega, somebody introduced me to jazz. And then I got stuck there till today. Till today, angpumi. But then, you know, the journey, yegulalela the music from the radio, you know, a bit of rock, reggae here and there, you know, moving on to jazz and then understanding masofika jazz, kutsi, you know, it's like.
It's also a different discipline.
Yes. Common. And yaksi the understanding more of the different genres lakona out there. So, you know. On that one.
Another lesson.
Okay, which is?
Exposing thyself to these multiple different art forms, in a sense, in order for your own personal growth. That's what I'm getting. Because as a musician, of course, it's quite imperative and important that you expose yourself to as many genres as possible.
Don't be ignorant.
Yeah, because... each one of those has something to give
on a musical
perspective. Especially about a little jazz. I feel like basically every genre takes something from jazz. I think like that's like that almost the origin of music.
Yes, so I think that's why I got stuck there.
Yeah.
Because then I keep realizing there's a bit of, you know, reggae in this thing, there's a bit of rock in this thing. So till today I'm still stuck there.
Your home ground.
Yeah. I'm still playing around with it.
And oh yeah, I forgot to ask this. You know how we tend to almost have arguments with the parents?
Oh yeah.
In terms of our passion.
Yes.
Did you ever experience such?
Yes, I did.
Okay. I'm not the only one.
Baba worried, you know, as a cooler, you understand what, you know, how they thought.
Yes, yes.
Okay, mina, I have an argument with my mom. Sangkatsile adversity, you know, I get a piece job. So ngiyahola, nhlanhlale, it was quite a biggish amount of money. Yeah, so,
50 million.
So, with the money, I had to pay the rest of my fees. And then with the other one, that's where she came in to ask, okay, what are you going to do with the other, the rest of the money?
Yeah.
So I'm like, no, I'm insane. I think there are better things you can do with the money than getting al guitar. And, you know, I had to, you know, put my points now. Why?
Yes.
I said to her, Mage, you have to let me buy a guitar because I had a piss job and now ngitum 70, and without a guitar I'll go insane. So I said, So at that time, besengathi the role edlalwa guitar empilweni yami, I knew the feeling that I had every time I played it. So that's why ngamtshela ukuthi, you know, I don't have a job right now, and I need that guitar to keep me
grounded.
So she let me buy it. So till today, I'm still having it.
Thank you, Mom.
Yes.
Thank you so much, Mom.
Thank you very much, Mom, for allowing me to have that, to buy that guitar.
Man, nah, man. We so much love our parents.
Yeah.
Even though sometimes it's about stress.
A lot.
Siyabonga, they actually come through for us when we need it the most. So, guys, it's been such a wonderful time. Any parting words from you in terms of motivating fellow aspiring artists, in a sense, who, of course, are in the bid to learn an instrument or anything of that sort? Like, you know, any words of wisdom?
I'd say learn. Learn. Ekhuleni kwami music, I realized kutsi kunebantfu laba gifted. Like they don't need much learning to do this thing.
Yes.
It just, you know,
boom.
It just happens.
Yeah.
But even if you're that kind of person, learn so that utokona understand what you're doing at the end of the day.
Yeah.
Because mina, there was a time whereby, because Bengilsanza al-Gitar, I could compose songs, but I never understood any of the things that I was doing. But then when I started learning, my journey of, you know, music, I kept on getting more teachers.
Okay.
And to get people who taught me and made me understand. what I was doing. Now, kufunza kukusita, especially, you know, understanding music, kukusita in broadening the creativity yako. Because now you have knowledge, and with that knowledge, you can do a lot of things. Okay?
Yeah.
Kukusita, again, to be able to communicate with other musicians, because what if you have something, a song, that, you know...
So funny. Okay, cala kuphi mpathi.
Yes. What's the key? You understand?
X sharp.
Yes. Which doesn't exist, obviously. Yes. So you do need to learn so that you don't understand the look to when done. It talks it nalogu kula. Mean, you know, the information that my teachers gave me till today angai 70s young. And I've been playing for quite some time. So the knowledge is still in me, but I'm still working on it day in, day out. So what am I saying in this? I'm saying ngutsi ngalokuthi nginenknowledge. There won't be an end to this thing.
Yeah.
Ngizoqhubeka because there's still a lot for me to try and implement. So you know, don't depend on the art that you have. Learn. Learn and understand. That will, you know, expand you to, you know.
Great art.
Yeah. So learn, people. No, it's a self-pass music. Just keep on learning.
Man.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't say anything after that. It's self-explanatory. Learn, people. Yeah. Learn. Yeah. In anything and in everything that is in front of you. Your gift is pretty much only halfway there if it's not bolstered with some critical learning into it. So invest in your craft on a daily basis. You know, you have the internet, read up, watch tutorials, videos, download ebooks or whatever. Learn, as Mzwakila has stated.
Yes.
Mzwakila, Mr. Twala, thank you so much, man, for joining
thank
us here,
Jeff. Thank you for having me.
Nah, it's been such a beautiful day and a beautiful conversation you've had today.
Okay.
Dear listeners, I pray and hope that you guys learned a lot from today's conversation, as per the norm, of course. So yeah, do have a wonderful day, evening or afternoon, whatever, what time you are. I'm already deep, man. I'm really eager to go learn now. So yes, it's been Joga Flavored Motivation Wednesday. Do have an epic day. We love you. God bless. Like, share, subscribe. Joga Flavored.
Add more flavor.
JF. Add more flavor.